నెక్స్ట్ టాపిక్ ఆప్టో ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ డివైసెస్. నెక్స్ట్ టాపిక్ ఆప్టో ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ డివైసెస్. So in this optoelectronic devices, we discuss about the three devices. One is a photodiode, next one is a solar cell, next one is a LED. In optoelectronic device, we discuss about photodiode. First one is about photodiode and second one is a solar cell. And next one is a LED. We have to discuss one by one. Okay, first one is a photodiode. Very simple. In this first one, photodiode I am taking here. Here photodiode is nothing but a PN junction diode. Photodiode is nothing but what, sir? It is a PN junction diode. It is a PN junction diode. What is doing? What is the work of photodiode? Photo means what? Photon energy. It converts photon energy. It converts photon energy into electrical energy. Electrical energy. So what's doing, sir? If take a PN junction diode, when allows a photon on that, automatically current produces. That is a photodiode. What is the photon energy? You already know photon energy E is equals to h nu. If h nu energy falls on a PN junction diode, current produces. That's why this is a optoelectronic devices. Opto, optical energy, electronic. So that is a current. It's converting optical energy into current. In that first one is a photodiode. Photodiode is what, sir? That is a PN junction diode. What is doing? It is converting photon energy into electrical energy. In which bias we have to operate? We have forward and reverse bias. In which bias we have to operate? We have to operate this one in again reverse bias. Again in reverse bias. Now here I'm drawing a circuit diagram to understand the photodiode. Okay, so circuit diagram is very simple. You take a P part and N part. PN junction diode, na? We have to take P and N. It is a PN junction diode I'm taking. See, this is a junction and this one is a depletion layer. Okay, this part is P and this part is N, PN junction diode. We have to operate in reverse bias. What is reverse bias, sir? P part must be connected to negative terminal of the battery. I have to connect negative terminal of the battery. N must be connected to positive terminal of the battery. It is a positive terminal of the battery. I am applying some voltage. Okay, so photon energy must fall on that. Photon energy, see here, when some photon energy, light energy is falls on that, where is light energy falling? The light energy is falling at the junction, at this depletion layer. If light energy is falling, this is a light energy, photon energy, photons. What is the photons energy, sir? E is equals to h nu. Here I have energy gap for this PN junction diode. We have energy gap, forbidden energy gap. If this energy is more than forbidden energy gap, what is the condition? If this incident energy is more than forbidden energy gap, then what happens? Then what happens, sir? Here electrons and hole pairs produces. Electron and hole pairs produce. Here I am taking here. I am drawing. It is a conduction band and it is a valency band. You already know that. And what is this, sir? This one is a forbidden energy gap. Here what I'm doing, here I'm allowing a, these are the valency band consists of electrons. What I'm doing here, I'm allowing some incident energy. If this incident energy is greater than this energy gap, at that time what happens, this electron is jump into conduction band. See, this electron is going to conduction band. Automatically what forms, sir? Here it forms a hole. So what I am telling here, I am telling whenever photons having sufficient energy falls on a p-n junction diode, electron and hole pairs generates, that produces electron and hole pair. See, electron hole, that is a pair. If you observe, one more electron jump to conduction band, again one more electron hole pair generates. In that way, here what forms are electron and hole pairs generates. Electron hole pairs generates. See, this P terminal is connected to negative terminal. Automatically what happens, sir? Here a hole is generated. For example, these are the holes and these are the electrons. These are the electrons. In which direction those are moving? Here what, sir? This is a negative terminal. It is a positive terminal. We already know plus and minus attracts. This negative terminal attracting the holes. That's why this hole is moving towards the P region. Holes are moving towards the P region because of the electric field. In the same manner, these electrons are moving towards the positive terminal. See, electrons are moving there. These electrons are moving towards the N region and holes are moving towards the P region. So what you are observing here, electron hole pairs generates, and this generated electrons moves towards P region and holes moves, hole moves towards which region, sir? N region. See, electrons are moving towards, electrons are moving towards the N region and holes are moving towards the P region. At that time what happens? See, here positive charge is more, positive charge is more. Then negative charge is more, that produces an EMF. Automatically an EMF develops. EMF develops. If EMF is there, automatically we will get a current by connecting the resistor. EMF is nothing but voltage. EMF is nothing but voltage. If voltage is there, if you connect through a resistor, you convert that voltage into current. This is called as a photodiode. What is doing, sir, here photodiode? Photodiode is nothing but a PN junction diode. That one operates in reverse bias. If you operate in reverse bias, less amount of current passes because of minority charge carriers. Whenever photons having sufficient energy, more than energy gap, falls on a junction diode, automatically electron hole pairs generated. These electrons and holes are moving towards the N region and P region because of this electric field. Automatically, electron number, hole number increases, positive charge, negative charge increases, that results a EMF. Automatically, these charge carriers are moving, current passes. So in this way, current passes. So what is doing, sir? This diode converting photon energy into electrical energy. Okay. If you increase the photon incident energy, if you increase the intensity of this photon, what happens? We have to check in VI characteristics. What is VI characteristics? Simple. That is a graph between voltage and current. I'm drawing VI characteristics. of what, sir? VI characteristics of photodiode. What happening, sir, here? See, if you take in a reverse bias, I'm taking in a reverse bias. This one is forward bias and this one is a reverse bias. In reverse bias, what is the current, sir? Current is in microamps, less amount of current. This is the reverse voltage. See, if I apply some intensity of light at that time, you get current like this. This is the current. This is the current for what, sir? This applied intensity. In this way, we have this current. If I increase the, if I allow the more incident light, if this light has more intensity at that time, more electron hole pairs generated, more current produces. So if intensity is more, automatically current is more. If you further increase the intensity of this incident light, again number of electron hole pairs more, that's why current is more. So what is the meaning here? If we increase the, if intensity of incident light, intensity of incident light increases, automatically what happens, sir? Current increases, current also increases. Increases. See, for a smaller intensity of incident, this one is the current. Now see, this one is the more current. If I increase the intensity, I'm getting more current. You further increase the intensity, I get more current. What is the conditions are here? Here, this I3 intensity is greater. I3 is greater compared to what? I2. This I2 is greater compared to what? I1. So I3 is greater, I2 is greater, I1. What is doing this photodiode? This photodiode converting light energy into electrical energy. If you allow more intensity of light, you get the more current. This is a photodiode.